Well, I thought you might need some encouragement, so I thought you know.
Know what?
Well, you could come to my club, the Literature Club. It's so fun. There are a few girls, and cupcakes, and drama. I mean, what?
And thus, today marks the day I sold my soul for Monica. I mean, this cupcake.
Natalie, you certainly have a big mouth for someone who keeps a manga collection in the club room.
Wait, I need to start something. I nod to myself with newfound determination. I nod to myself with newfound Undertale joke. I follow behind as Sayori hums and skips around the hallway. Honestly, it feels like I'm taking a kid to the mall or something. Amen! Later, I find pleasure in the simplest things sometimes. I'm already too corrupted from the internet to say, yeah, I don't like the word pleasure anymore. Just because of reasons. A performance? Of what kind?
Well, everyone is gonna take turns on stage and recite their favorite poem.
Oh, that sounds kind of dull.
Roman, you're not thinking about it the right way at all. It's not just about reading poems. It's about performing them. Like, you say the lines of the poem like, "Between my feet, the last remaining flower beckons to me. I twist the stem, freeing it from its clinging roots, caressing the final joyous moment between my fingers. But to what ends have I summoned this joy? For now, when I look in every direction, the once propitious field before me is but a barren wasteland." Like that.
Sayori, how do I put this? I'm sure it's just me, but it's impossible for me to take you seriously when you talk like that.
Yeah, you mean. Let's begin the mission.
The mission, eh? It's been a long time since I've spent time with Sayori like this. But in the end, she hasn't changed one bit. She's nothing but a ball of sunshine, drawing happy vibes from the world around her. And converting them inside of herself into dark stuff. Anyway!
Will you give me your poem? I kinda want to keep it.
Huh? Why?
Because, well, it's the first time you've written something for me.
Sayori, you completely misunderstood. I didn't write this for you. Are you listening anymore? Well, whatever. I'll give it to you when we go home.
Really?
Snap.
I broke my pencil.
Sayori hastily bends down to pick up the piece she dropped. But being inattentive of her surroundings, she bumps right into me.
Sorry.
It's fine. I wanted to make a joke, but then nope. Yuri.
Please. It makes it easier for me if you don't express any concern. Besides, I have my books with me.
That's the best thing.
That's all I need.
Well, you not only your books, but also that one thing that I don't like about you. If only there's something long and sharp in your skirt. This can come out as weird. But, I mean...
Sayori has been working on posters, and I've designed some pamphlets we can give out during the event.
Okay, that's great and all. But that doesn't tell us what we are actually going to be doing for the event.
Oh, sorry. I thought you heard about it already.
I will not make this joke again, okay?
Aber das sagt uns nicht, was wir eigentlich für das Event tun werden.
Ach, Entschuldigung. Ich dachte, du hättest schon davon gehört.
Hab was gehört?
You know. The bird is a word.
Oh, well, a bird, bird, bird. The bird's a word.
Lazy. Bro, ah. Damn it. Ah! Sayori! And sorry, I know it's not your problem. Also, thunder is coming in 3, 2, 1. Thunder? Because I saw right now lightning. What? What do you mean by that? Are you okay? Cat? Cat, are you okay? What are you looking at? I don't like when you look up, because that just means that something is there. And I don't like when there's something up there. Hopefully. Anyway. Is there a grasshopper again? Good one. Anyway.
I'm saying that maybe the thing on her mind is here. Siri talks about you more than anything else, you know?
I don't know what just happened there. Okay, I'm sorry, but I will look for that. So I'm back. One box from the radio just dropped for some reason, and I have no idea why. Hopefully it's not a ghost, because if it's a ghost, then I say I'm gonna fish you. Anyway.
Okay, everyone.
After some time passes, Monica calls out to the club room.
Why don't we share our poems now?
Before I know it, everything is back to normal. Everyone goes to retrieve their poems, and I do the same. I make eye contact with Monica, and she's masked at me. I wonder what she was talking about with Sayori. So, let's go with the longest one, because, oh boy. Sayori doesn't look too enthusiastic about spending time with me. I guess if she changed her mind, she'll come to me. But I should leave her be for now. What? Natsuki?
Finally!
Eh?
This one is good. I was wondering how long it will take you.
Alright.
Yeah, just don't listen to what anyone else says. Especially Yuri.
She just ignores me. I mean, that's okay to me, but why? Ich gehe mit Yuri auf mein Zimmer. Aber sofort schaut sie sich neugierig um, was mich ziemlich nervös macht.
Es ist so aufgeräumt.
Das habe ich vorher noch schnell erledigt.
Das ist sehr aufmerksam von dir.
Nein. Es wäre mir total peinlich, wenn in meinem Zimmer Chaos herrschen würde, wenn du hier bist.
Oh. Tja, ich räume eigentlich gerne auf. Ich hätte dir helfen können.
Ah. Ich glaube, das wäre dann noch peinlicher gewesen. Halt! Nicht da reinschauen! Hineinschauen! Ich ziehe Yuris Handgelenk von meiner Tischschublade weg, die sie gerade öffnen wollte. Yeah, where's the porn, by the way? Where's the adult thing, by the way? I just wonder. Can you find the place where the main character could have hidden the adult thing? Because I don't see anything. Oh, wow. Ich hatte gar keine Ahnung, dass du so schwere Geschütze auffahren willst. Out of context, is this weird? Am meisten schwere Geschütze. Anyway. Aber was hat das mit dem Holzding auf sich?
Oh, das hier. Das ist ein Diffuser für ätherische Öle. Wie gut kennst du dich mit Aromatherapie aus?
Überhaupt gar nicht.
Ah, wirklich? Der Diffuser ist einer meiner Lieblingshilfsmittel zum Erschaffen eines positiven Ambientes. Nur durch die Auswahl der Öle oder Kräuter kannst du die Stimmung im Raum verändern.
Mhm, ja, von normalen Jungs im Zimmer zu... Oh boy, it's getting hot in here! Within 10 seconds! Juri nimmt den Zylinder und schaltet ihn an der Unterseite ein. Kurz darauf wird ein dünner Dampfstrahl aus der kleinen Öffnung an der Spitze geblasen. Wow, das riecht großartig. Für was für eine Art Stimmung ist das gedacht?
Das hier ist ein ätherisches Jasminöl.
Jasmin ist auch so ein Aphrodisiakum. Also, Aphrodisiakum. Oder mit anderen Worten, it's getting hot in here.
Es duftet süßig und blumig, nicht wahr?
Ja, das beschreibt es recht gut.
Ich habe für die Veranstaltung Jasmin gewählt, da es nicht nur für Entspannung gesorgt. Jasmin versteckt deine Gefühle und du spürst, wie sie durch deinen Körper strömen.
That is good, German. Also, it's getting hot in here. Sorry.